こんにちは、ジャパニーズアモのミサです。
Day 4
4日目
The words that I want you to remember today are
動物
Animal
動物植物植物
Plant
魚魚
Fish And a few more from example sentences that I'm gonna give you. Alright, so first,
動物動物
which means animal. If you look at the kanji, the second kanji, 物 is the same kanji as the word, for example,
食べ物食べ物
which means food. 食べ物 comes from two words,
食べる
to eat, and 物 think,or an object. And this 動物, this 物, it has a different reading, but it has the same meaning because it's the same kanji. It means thing. And the first kanji comes from the verb 動く, 動く, which means to move. So it's like animated object, like moving thing. And that means animal. 動物So I love animals. So
動物が大好きです。動物が大好きです。
And you can, for example, ask
動物の中で何が一番好きですか?動物の中で何が一番好きですか?
So 動物の中で This 中で means inside.But you can translate like among animals. So 動物の中で何が一番好きですか? What do you like the most? Or you could ask more like
どの動物が一番好きですか? どの動物が一番好きですか?
And for example, you could say
犬が一番好きです。犬が一番好きです。犬
dog.
Or猫が一番好きです。猫が一番好きです。猫
cats. I have to say I like dogs the best. But I also have pet rats.
ネズミ can mean a mouse or rat.
But the type of rats that I have is called
fancy rat.
Fancy rat.
Fancy rat
も大好きです。I love fancy rats too. And then you might as well remember the word.
動物園動物
園 which means zoo
動物園
This 漢字園 means garden or park So for example, the normal park we say
公園公園
And this is also another word that I want you to remember today 公園 park So you could for example say
友達と公園で遊んだ友達と公園で遊んだ
I hang out with my friends or I played with my friends at the park. Alright, next.
植物植物
So just like 動物 this 物 is like object, right? And then 植 comes from the verb
植える植える
which means to plant. So like you can say 花を植える花を植える And this 花 is another word that I want you to remember today. There are so many words today, I'm so sorry. 花 flowers. And if you know the word for flowers, you have to know the word for tree.
木
木 Easy, right? So 木
花
But when we talk about flowers, we often say
お花
お花 We put the honorific prefix to make the word 花 flowers.Sound prettier.
Ohana.
By the way, in another kanji, hana can also mean nose.
Hana.
And the intonation is exactly the same.
Hana.
Hana. So, shokubutsu, plants.
Hana,
flowers.
Ki,
trees. The next word is
sakana. Sakana.
Fish.
Sakana.
So, you could say sakana
ga.泳いでいる魚が泳いでいる
泳ぐ to swim 泳いでいる is swimming right now. And since we had the word for zoo, we should remember the word for aquarium, which is 水族館. Yeah, you thought 動物 and is how we say zoo. So you might have thought it should be 魚園. Yeah, I know, right? It should be 魚園. But fish doesn't really belong to a park. We have a different word. 水族館. But if you remember this suffix 館 from the word 映画館 or 図書館, it might not be too bad. So 映画館, 図書館, 水族館. Basically, all these places are where people look at things, like read things or look at things, watch things, right? You watch something to learn, then we use this 館 usually. So 水族館, aquarium. So the words that I want you to remember are 動物, animals, and possibly 犬 and 猫, dogs and cats. 植物, plants, and 木, trees, 花, flowers, and also 魚, fish, and 水族館, aquarium, and also the word for park, 公園. Alright, I hope you learned a lot today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And see you tomorrow. また明日. Bye bye.